Luminarium, what I love about it, and I do say love, is that there are topics in a Luminarium that you may not think about. You come across this exhibit, it catches your eye for various reasons, it's designed that way, but once you start to interact with it, once you put your hands onto it or you step onto it, it makes all those concepts come to a realization for you. It makes it real for the person, right?
The community has been almost unfathomably excited and positive about this project. We had a strong sense of mission coming from the Exploratorium, and one of the things we confirmed in this first phase was alignment between the goals here and what our mission as the Exploratorium was in the world. And that was tied to a long-term goal here of diverse workforce development. It was really about making a place for the whole community.
In order to achieve the goal of creating a really inclusive place, all the people who were developing this agreed that we should have a lot of different voices to kind of co-create this place so that it could be something that is truly of and by the people of Omaha. I was really excited that Exploratorium, as our programmatic partners, had a similar vision to how they wanted to design the exhibits here.
One of the overwhelming favorites has been the how silent can you be walking across the gravel? There's always a line for that. But I mean, it's like picking your favorite child, right? There's so many that have turned out so good. I mean, the exhibit design has exceeded my expectations. They were evolved from the very beginning with HDR, who was our designer on the building, with what the building, you know, ought to be and how it might, you know, the inside of it ought to work. And so that was, to me, really exciting.
I love where an entity that has been in the museum space like this is able to work with us, be our partner, where we can lean on their expertise and what they've learned. So we're not recreating the wheel. We're actually making the wheel run better.
Illuminator basically helps facilitate all of the exhibits here. We do demonstrations like the cow eye dissection, the magic demonstration, the flower dissections, and the perception goggles. And we kind of just help engage guests who are walking through the museum and looking at all the exhibits, or, you know, guests who have questions about the exhibit.
I just think of this place as like the place I wish I had when I was in third grade, because man, I would have been in here all day just going up the stairs, downstairs, talking about sound waves, cells.
Our Illuminators are our largest staff in the team. So without the Illuminators, we would not be able to run the museum, which actually it's really exciting because that holds us accountable on making sure that we are engaging our youth from age 15 to come to this space, gather some skills, sharpen some skills, and just be curious members of the community.
Being able to bring in aspects of the culture and communities that I know in this city and give them space here, and then also give space for people who haven't maybe engaged in those communities. So we did Science of Skateboarding, and we had some prototype exhibits where people could learn the first elements of skateboarding, which is like balance. So we had people from the fingerboard community in showcasing how the extremities of your feet operate the same way as extremities of your hands. And that engagement, which was really cool, people could build a skateboard, take it apart, kind of learn the mechanics and engineering behind what elements that make up a skateboard and what they do. Kind of just let them engage in, like, what's this feel like? And blah, blah, blah. So it was a cool way to bring it into the space.
Yes, it's a great place for educators. Any science teacher, any math teacher, any STEM teacher, and I would even say from the standpoint of history, there's some great history involved with some of the exhibits and how you can see stuff has changed over time. There's a lot of social sciences in a lot of exhibits. And you know, most teachers would love to get their students outside of the building and out into the yard or the neighborhood to do more. The Luminarium has all that right there.
I'm
so excited to finally see it in action and to see the way the community is engaging with this place. I mean, you look around here and people have giant grins on their faces. You see community members talking to strangers, you know, they're building the arch and they're like, we need a tall guy, get over here, you know, and people are meeting and engaging with one another. Parents are with their kids exploring new ideas. I mean, it's just incredible.